Welcome to this Transcriptive tutorial going over how multicam support works in Transcriptive 3.0 Rough Cutter. This version has some improvements in multicam support, and I'm going to be using it in Premiere 2022 for this video. We recommend using the most recent versions of both Premiere and Transcriptive for the best performance, and you'll need at least Premiere 14.3.2 for this multicam support to work. Transcriptive can transcribe multicam sources and merge clips in clip mode, and the transcript will be synced with the clip just like it would be with a standard video or audio file. Before transcribing with the multicam source selected in the project panel, you can see the name of the multicam source here and click transcribe to transcribe it. Before you do that though, we want to make sure the correct audio tracks are going to be transcribed, and you can do that by right-clicking the multicam source, selecting open in timeline, and whatever tracks are unmuted here are the audio that Transcriptive is going to transcribe. You can also batch transcribe multiple multicam sources by selecting them all in the project panel, clicking the top left menu in Transcriptive and selecting batch project. This lets you transcribe multiple multicam clips at once instead of queuing them up one at a time. And you'll see the number of multicams selected here and the total cost. So make sure everything here looks correct before you submit it. You can also align existing transcripts to your multicam sources by clicking import and selecting one of these supported formats like a plain text file or an SRT file, importing that file. And then once it's imported, click transcribe and change the transcribe width dropdown to alignment. You can check out our tutorial videos on single and batch alignment or using batch project to transcribe clips and sequences for more info on how to do those things. But to just transcribe this single multicam source, you want to select it with clip mode on and then just click transcribe. You'll see the total length, total cost, and be able to select the language. So make sure all of this is correct and then click continue to start transcribing. Once transcribing is done, the transcript returns and will play back in sync with your multicam source clip.
And she came to pay rent one day and she said,
"This transcript is saved to this multicam item in your Premiere project panel. So whenever you click on this with clip mode on, the transcript will automatically load." Multicam transcripts will also transfer between different projects if you're using Premiere Productions, so you can drag a multicam clip to a new project, and that transcript will also load when you select the multicam in the other project. With this transcript in clip mode, you can use Ctrl-I to add an endpoint, and then Ctrl-O to add an outpoint. And then insert that at the playhead location by using Control Comma on Windows or Control 8 on Mac. And this way you can build a rough sequence by using the transcript to find sound bites that you want. You can then switch off clip mode to load this sequence transcript that will be in sync with the sequence, but it will get out of sync if you start to make edits on the timeline. So to resync the transcript text, click the top left menu in Transcriptive and select Sync Transcript to Sequence Edit. Click Confirm. And now this is back in sync.
Sometimes I can hang out with those.
This text, when you do this, is being pulled from the original clip transcript, which is our multicam source, and not from the sequence transcript. So it will overwrite any edits you've made to the text of the sequence transcript. And this just means that you should either edit your text in clip mode first or wait until your sequence edit is finished and synced and then edit the text of the sequence then. Finally, when working with multicam clip transcripts, make sure that you are using them with the source selected in clip mode and not with the open timeline option that you get from right-clicking on a multicam source. You can load the transcript here with clip mode off, but you'll get a playback error when you try to play the transcript in sync. Same thing for when you have the multicam review turned on in your sequence. You can still click words to jump the timeline playhead location, or use the sync with playhead button to jump the text to your playhead location. But while you're selecting the camera angle in your sequence using multicam record, you'll just need to start playback from the timeline and not from transcriptive. Once you turn multicam review back off, you can start playback from transcriptive again.
What I really love about teaching at Inspire is that we're...
And that's how multicam works with transcriptive. If you have any questions or if you want a free trial of transcriptive, send us an email at sales@digitalanarchy.com.